That's awesome to hear, and I'm sorry everybody for being no-show from multiple things just like that, like you guys saw yesterday. The line of fans is huge, and as you can see right now, there's also quite a few people. And there's a lot of fans, a lot of cosplayers, a lot of amazing people in the community. And I've heard this question over and over again, and everybody's wondering, and if that list has been updated from yesterday, but what is your best or craziest or funniest fan interaction or cosplay interaction? Have you ever seen anything that just has blown you away, blown your socks off?
Well, I have to say that the reaction to all of our Sandvich videos has been so wonderful. And being known as a cute old person, still having fun at the age of 70, I think is wonderful.
Sitting in a restaurant and being recognized from these viral videos has really been a shame. You know, and just because our faces now are associated with those voices for the first time in our careers as voice actors. Even when I was an actor on a TV series from 40 years ago called Toobly Zoo, I don't know if anybody remembers that one, but. I was under a lot of makeup and had tears on the top of my head and things like that. But yesterday, just walking across Starbucks, and somebody had the Jimmy John's and said, "Sandwich."
Yeah! one stands out to me. I have to say, one time we were in D.C. and this little 10-year-old girl came up to us with her father, and she was cosplaying a turtle.
We clicked.
But I'm just trying to understand what kind of universe you guys have created, which is so welcoming and so much fun, and you can kind of step outside the normie world of chaos and consternation and hatred and whatever, and come here and live in a different universe, which is, you know, just ideal. So I'm pleased to be a part of it, and I have you to thank for that. Yes, it is a crazy series you guys came up with, and I think it fits the comic, the humor of the game perfectly. And we've been wondering a lot, the community, when you guys film that, do you get recognized? Because I know that a lot with the faces and all that might not match up, but definitely do they hear the voices? Does that mean, has that been determined?
We were on the monorail in Seattle. The driver of the monorail, of course, these people are working for the MTA, and this wonderful young woman, you know, you're supposed to pay every time, you know, the monorail goes for a mile. It goes from, you know, Center House to Westlake. And if anybody's been to Seattle, you know, it's just a short trip. You're supposed to pay each way. Well, she realized who we were, and she just let us stay on the monorail and do all our, you know, videoing. And she was so supportive, and of course, we took a picture with her at the end. But it was so great. She knew who we were. She was a Team Fortress 2 fan.
And we were filming a Tower No Refunds. That was really the first time that, I mean, we were in a park and there were a lot of people walking around.
Just the title is ridiculous.
I know. But people come up and talk to us while we're filming, and it was the first time because I'm kind of the director, I'm kind of keeping things going and stuff like that. And these guys are, oh, fans, let's just chat for a while. And so, you know, the shoot was supposed to take, I think, 12 minutes, and then maybe 3.5 hours. But it's just a whole lot of fun because people hear the voices. Even now, more people associate with our voices than with our faces. Yeah. And if they hear it, you know, they hear heavily, Sandvich! You know, they come for miles.
I can remember 10 years or so ago when my son was still in the middle school, I think, and we were going out to a yogurt shop in some local mall, and he said, Dad, we're going to go when my friend runs this yogurt shop. That's his part-time job. I just want to warn you that he is an enormous fan of donut. He likes to do the international. I do one voice in donut, and I be in poker in donut. And he said, just be prepared when you walk in there that, you know, he might be acting strange because the poker is his favorite character. And sure enough, we walked in his yogurt shop, and the man's hand was shaking. I realized that for a very small select group of Americans, and we're actually people all over the world, we are major celebrities from these games. Just because of our voices. And it was fantastic. I thought, you know, at least to my kids and to your generation, you know, we've done something really significant and we've given something to you. I'm not sure what, but you like it.
Waiting on me doesn't believe that my brother is the heavy. Can you say something? And I said, yes, Robin, I am standing up with this guy. And she got such a good deal.
In fact, I said, give me a free yogurt that night, too. Free yogurt's always good. Yeah. So, a lot of people also, this is a question that so we're just going to answer it right here. If you know any of these people want in the future to be an actor, anything like that, what's the advice you give them?
get in an acting class. They're lots of fun. And I think they're also very therapeutic because you learn to let go of your inhibitions. I've never had any inhibitions. But anyway, get an acting class because all of us started out with theater training and dance and music, and it's fun. It's just plain fun.
You don't know where your talents lie, so. You know, my first voiceover class, I had no idea, what voiceover was really. And I just started making a list of, these are some of the voices that I can do. I mean, my career has just gone crazy with all these different little niches, but those walls found out people acting if I could do things. So just start out, and it's so easy to get a simple setup with a mic and recording, but everybody can do it on your iPhone now, with your memo. Yeah. And just start practicing and start doing it.
Even in music, Bateman learned how to write music by imitating Haydn. Imitating your favorite characters on TV, record yourself, and see how active you are. That can really train your ear.
Yep.
If you're trying to do the sign or something like that, go ahead and record yourself and try to analyze, okay, is this too high, is it too low? Am I shaping the vowels correctly? What is he doing that I'm not doing? And you can do a lot of training yourself. But also, I think it's important to know that, like, when Al and I were in school, video games weren't the ghost of a glimmer in any tech guy's eye. There were no video games. This was in the 70s, and I didn't get into video games until the 90s. And I trained to be a composer, my mom trained as an opera singer, so the arts in general will get you prepared for any kind of art form that takes place in this time, any kind of storytelling. And know that 20 years from now, there could be a thing that none of us have even conceived of that you might be able to see. So you know, leave yourself open to new things, because none of us saw video games coming out of
the top. And to tail on to that, I would say develop as many skills, performing skills as you can. I wanted to get into musicals. I didn't even really know how to sing when I got to Seattle. I took some singing lessons. And I started getting cast in musicals. And but then I realized that that's one useful skill, but if you don't read music and dance something, then you're at a disadvantage. And it's harder that way. So if you can juggle, if you can play instruments, John plays I don't know how many instruments. If you can dance, if you can do mime, all of those things will come in handy at some point. I would add that in my career, the one thing I wish I had spent more time doing, the one thing I wish I had spent more time on is improv. Because you are always called upon to, people hire you not because they know what they want you to do. They want you to do something wonderful right away and tell them what they want. So I would say learn how to improvise. Because in so many areas, especially in the voiceover area, you'll find that very, very useful.
And by the way, I teach improvisation.
A lot of these characters are created too. The writers basically brought us into a room and gave us some lines, but a lot of the lines that you hear in the game came out of all of us improvising.
And just,
questions. But there are a few rules though. Like, make sure you have no questions about updating your content, type content, because, you know, NDAs.
Because we don't know.
And of course, well, don't ask the questions that I just ask, like, add things that are Google it. And then just, yeah, keep the questions civil. And, so I think we're going to get a mic set up real soon. And while we do that, I was wondering, can we get some voice mics?
Fight, she can drink.